And today's video is going to be all about skincare. I'm going to tell you how you can create your own skincare routine and a few do's and don'ts of makeup. So starting with how you can create your own skincare routine. The first step of any skincare routine is removing your makeup. So you can't sleep with makeup on because it will cause acne, blackheads, clogged pores, excessive oil production and whatnot. So you need to remove your makeup, and for that you need a good makeup remover. The one that I've been using is Garnier Micellar Cleansing Water. And if you prefer using a cleansing milk, then I would suggest Nivea Refreshing Cleansing Milk for this one, for removing your makeup. It wouldn't work as good as a makeup remover because it wouldn't remove heavy eye makeup or mascara as a makeup remover would do. So you can try it if you want to. So these are the two makeup removers and makeup removers that I've been using. Now moving on to step number two, which is cleaning your face after removing your makeup. That is removing the dirt that you have on your face and any traces of makeup that is left from your face. So for that you need a facial cleanser or a face wash. The one that I am using is Neutrogena Deep Clean Facial Cleanser. It is for normal to oily skin, and the bottle is almost empty and I'm almost done using it. So after this one is over, I'm going to shift to Ozori face wash, which I received in my July fab bag. So this was the facial cleanser. That is the step number two. Now moving on to step number three is exfoliating your skin. That is using good scrubs and exfoliators. Now exfoliating your skin removes blackheads, reduces blackheads and whiteheads, unclogs pores. So exfoliating your skin is very important. But overdoing it can lead to tearing and scarring of your skin, which can lead to accumulation of bacteria and can further cause infections. So you should not overdo it. I suggest you should do it twice or thrice, maximum thrice, and not more than that. There are two facial scrubs that I've been using. This one is almost empty, like I've completely used this one. So this is from Biotique Bio Papaya Tan Removal Scrub for all skin types. This one is for all skin types. This is made up of 100% natural ingredients. So I used this during my summer break for removing tan. Now this was about the first facial scrub. Now moving on to the second one that I'm using is from Enador Charcoal Face Scrub. I have reviewed this face scrub on my blog as well, so I'll be mentioning the link of the review of this product in the description box below. So if you guys want, you can check it out too. So this is a charcoal face scrub, and it has reduced my blackheads a lot. People with acne prone skin can use this one, and it would really work for them because clogged pores, acne and everything is a really big issue. I've almost used this. I'm almost done with this one as well. Like only one third or one fourth of it is left. I'm pretty sure you guys can't see it. So only one third or one fourth of it is left. So this was all about exfoliation. Now moving on to the fourth step of your skincare routine is toning your skin. A toner usually balances out the pH of your skin. And the one that I've been using is from Amway, and it is the Artistry Essentials Balancing Toner. I'm not sure whether this toner is available in regular departmental stores and online on other websites, because I bought this one from Amway, from an Amway agent. So you can check out this one on the Amway website if you guys would like to buy it. So this was about the toner and the fourth step of your skincare routine. Now moving on to the fifth step is moisturizing your skin. That is hydrating your skin, retaining moisture in your skin. Hydrating your skin is really important, and it is important for all skin types. People feel that if they have oily skin, they don't need to hydrate or moisturize their skin, but this is actually wrong. You need to moisturize your skin even though you have oily skin, because excessive production of oil and sebum and retaining moisture, hydration are two different things. So moisturizing the skin is really important. The one that I've been using is again from Neutrogena, oil-free moisture for combination skin. This is, I don't think there are a lot of moisturizers available in market for combination skin. So I've been using this for almost about 2 years. I'm stuck on this one. And if you guys know any other moisturizer which is perfect for combination skin, please let me know in the comment section below. I would love to try it. It is available for other skin types as well. So if you guys would like to buy this one, you can check out the Neutrogena website and buy one according to your skin type. So this was the fifth step. Now moving on to the sixth step, that is using a serum. I had reviewed a serum in my previous video as well. And now I'm going to tell you guys about how important it is to use a serum. Serums can treat your skin problems faster than any other thing that a moisturizer, scrub, toner would do. So using a serum is equally important. Now the serum that I've been using, as I've mentioned in my last video, is the Cocoon Hydrating Night Serum. Now There are both day and night serums available. I prefer night serums more because they can do their work, they can do their job without interference of the sun and UV rays. So I prefer night serums more than day serums. You can choose one according to your preference. This was all about serums, and now we are done with this step number 6 of a skincare routine. Moving on to step number 7, that is using mask, which is my personal favorite step. You can choose masks according to your skin type. So like for example, if you have dry skin, you can choose gel mask or sheet mask, which can retain moisture and hydrate your skin. And if you have oily skin, you can use clay mask that can control the excess production of oil. And if you have combination skin, you can use both. So, and if you're blessed with normal skin, you can use all of these face masks. So now moving on to the face mask that I personally love using. The first one is Innisfree Capsule Recipe Pack. I'm buying this one for the third or fourth time, I guess, and I love this one. It comes in a very small tiny container. So now moving on to the second mask, which is a sheet mask. This is from the Face Shop. Sheet masks have become really popular in the beauty industry these days. So you can try on sheet mask. It is completely hassle-free, easy to use. Anyone can use it, and it can be used on a daily basis as well. It comes in different varieties, different ranges, and you can choose it according to your skin type, your skin preferences, your skin problems, everything. So this was all about face masks, and now we are done with step number 7. So now moving on to step number 8, which is using an eye cream. If you have puffy eyes, dark circles, tired eyes, you can use an eye cream to get rid of it. Under eye creams can reduce wrinkles, under eye wrinkles, dark circles, and nourish your under eye area. The skin under your eye is very thin, so you need to choose the perfect eye cream for yourself really carefully and according to your need and what suits you and what does not suit you. So this was about your step number 8, which is an eye cream. The one that I am using is from Aroma Magic Under Eye Cream. This one is an eye cream that I have been using. Now moving on to step number 9, which is sun protection. And using a sunscreen is really important. Be it any season, you need protection from UV rays. So the one that I've been using is again from Amway Attitude Sunscreen Cream. It has SPF 30, and using a sunscreen is really important. And I don't think I need to tell everyone how important it is to protect yourself from UV rays. So choosing the perfect sunscreen for yourself with the perfect ingredients, SPF for yourself, is really important. And if you don't want to get tanned and if you don't want sunburns, use sunscreen. Please, please, please use sunscreen no matter what season it is. Using a sunscreen is really important. Or if you don't use sunscreens and sun lotions on a sun protection on a daily basis, your skin can show early signs of aging. And if you don't want to look old so soon, please use a sun protection for yourself. Now moving on to the 10th step, which is the last step of a skincare routine, is lip balms. Taking good care of your lips is as important as taking good care of your facial skin. I don't think anyone likes having dried, chapped lips with dead skin cells, so using a lip balm is really important. I would suggest you can use a lip scrub as well. I use a lip scrub from Juicy Chemistry, and the lip balms that I've been using is from Nivea Fruity Shine Strawberry, and the other one is from Maybelline Baby Lips. So you can use other lip balms as well. There are varieties of lip balms available in the market, so you can choose any one which you want. Lip balms usually hydrate and protect your lips, and if you have chapped and dried lips and you apply lipstick or any other lip product on it, the result wouldn't be as appealing and as good as it would be with if you have nourished, hydrated lips. So applying lip balm is also important. So now we are done with the 10 steps of your skincare routine, and this is how you can create your own skincare routine. I hope this helped you guys. Now moving on to do's and don'ts of skincare. I have listed down a few points in this cute diary which I would like to tell you guys. So the first point is getting at least 8 hours of sleep. It can benefit your skin. It can make your body as well as your skin feel fresh. It can nourish your skin. So getting 8 hours of sleep is really important. So the second point now is clean your phone screen daily. So if you have a dirty phone screen and then you again use it and take a call, answer a call, and the phone screen comes in contact with your skin, it can lead to acne, and the dirt or bacteria that is there on the phone can get in touch with the skin, and it is actually not good. That is actually not good for your skin. Now moving on to the third point, which is Never ever sleep with makeup on, because if sleeping with makeup on can lead to a lot of problems and while you're asleep, and if you're sleeping with makeup on, your skin wouldn't get nourished and it wouldn't feel fresh when you wake up the next morning, and you would notice there is a lot of oil production. I have noticed it because I have slept with makeup on, and I have noticed this personally, that there is a lot of oil production throughout the face. I have combination skin, so it was not only on my T-zone, that is all over my face, there was excessive oil production, and your skin gets really dirty. It gets really, you can feel the bad condition of your skin. Now moving on to the fourth and the final point is, don't touch your face if your hands aren't clean. Touching your face with dirty hands can do the same thing as touching, bringing your dirty phone in contact with your skin. So it's just also a bad habit. So you can keep these points in mind and have great healthy skin. So this was all for today's video. I hope you guys liked the video. If you did, please like and comment on the video and share it with your friends. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching this video. Love you. Bye.